Let's bring in Cole Smead. He's the president at Smead Capital Management for more on today's market action, what we've seen all week. So, Cole, I guess we'll just start with what we saw in the last 30 minutes. Just another huge swing in this market. What do you take away from a week like this?
Yeah, thanks for having me. So this week really plays down to economic sensitivity was the loser early in the week. And obviously today, things economically sensitive is what bounced hardest. So, you know, Sir John Templeton said, when you can see light at the end of the tunnel, it's too late. And in many ways, that's how this market's set up. On the places where people feel the safest, use names like Costco as an example, they just don't feel that's going to be affected much by what's going on in the economy over the next 2 or 3 years. As where places like energy, financials, they're pretty deathly afraid of the economic activity in the next 1 or 2 quarters particularly.
Hey, Jared Blicker here. I was just looking at some incredible moves, not only in the stock market, but also the bond market. We saw the 10-year rise after the official settlement, though. It rose, according to Bloomberg calculations, to 1%. This is after it hit the 30s, you know, at the beginning of the week. What does this say to you? Also, with the 2s-10 expanding here, we have the highest, the biggest yield curve expansion since mid-2018. What does that mean to you?
It's a perfect picture of what Templeton said. In other words, think you wake up this morning. I mean, people are looking, saying, gosh, what is going to go on tomorrow, was what people left Thursday with. And the worst part about today is if you were the owner of the 10-year treasury, you wake up, you find out you're getting killed, and you don't find out till later why. Just kind of like stocks have been treated prior in the week. And I think that could go on for a while because, I mean, this stimulus that the president's announced, It's better news than we had. At the same time, China had 15,000 people infected in a single day, exactly 30 days ago. And yesterday it was single digits. You have to literally stare into this and be hopeful and be optimistic on the economy. Otherwise, people are going to lose out on particularly good stock prices. And I'm not saying that as someone that would tell you that this is a great time to buy the index. Mm-hmm. I don't think it is. I think it's a wonderful time to buy particular stocks tied to the economy.
Well, so, and Cole, what have you been doing during this period? I mean, we've seen, you know, not just the indexes, but a number of companies trading significantly below, or, you know, trading off more than the index. Or, you know, we've seen a few outperformers here and there, but the washouts at the security level in many cases have been larger than what we've seen at the index. So have you been buying? Have you been selling? Have you just been sitting tight waiting for some clarity?
Yeah, we've been very patient to watch the insiders. So, you know, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, where was the largest insider buying that was going on? It was going on in the energy patch. So that was interesting. I mean, they just got absolutely obliterated. And in many cases, there were buyers in that space in the prior month as well. The financials, you know, the financials are a great way to bet on or against the economy. And obviously, most people looked and said, oh, if the economy is going to be terrible in the interim, I don't want to own those. And the reality is, the cost of capital rising, the net interest margins through the 210 spread, an example, movement on the 10-year. That's, you know, if we see what we had happen today, where you only find out later why things are changing, I think it's going to be a great time to be owner of a name like Bank America, who we do own. So it's like I said, this is all for the optimist. Mm-hmm. If you're not willing to take the risk and be the optimist, this is not your game going forward.
All right, Cole Smead, the president at Smead Capital. Thanks so much for the time today.
Thank you.
Hey, investors. Zach Guzman here. Are you interested in learning more about the markets and getting the latest financial news? Well, then click right here to subscribe to our Yahoo Finance YouTube channel. Get the latest up-to-the-minute market analysis, big interviews in the world of finance, and information on how to manage your money every day, wherever you are.